Oh, those bandits. And the guy.
And you, don't you butt in like a belch between two pints, because you're out of your fucking element.
So right. Make like a hare and sod off.
Leave him alone.
Let's pretend I didn't hear that. Now get out of here, before I get tired of playing make-believe.
I see you lot are tough in the town and nowhere else.
Fuck this, we're gonna let some dandy's boyfriend scare us. Let's show him how things are done on our turf.
Dandy boyfriend? What?
Thank you for your help. That's the only way to deal with this rabble. They beg for trouble.
And you're begging for trouble just coming here at this hour. Especially dressed like that.
I've come on business.
Good luck with that.
Wait. You helped me once. Perhaps you'd be willing to do it again. For more than a kind word this time.
What's involved? Just to be clear, I'm neither a bodyguard nor an assassin for hire.
Now, what makes you think I need either of those? I'd simply ask you to accompany me on a stroll. Should anything happen along the way, well, perhaps then you might need to do some work for your pay. What say you to that?
Agreed. I'll be right behind you.
Keep your hand on your hilt. As a general matter of precaution, of course.
Of course. Always do that when I'm out for a stroll.
Welcome to the waterfront. Where's the guy?
I'm afraid I had some unexpected adventures along the way. However, we can now focus on our core concern, and that is what matters.
Who's the fella followed you here?
He's my gardener. I never go anywhere without him. He's good luck, you see.
Just no funny stuff. Got it?
What's going on here?
Oh, listen. Mind watering those cornflowers over there?
No cornflowers here.
Look harder.
Right, on with it before winter snows surprise us. Got 4 quarts for you now. I can get you another 2 real quick. Provided you're not lying about demand.
I am Ginter de Laverac, and I never go back on my word. I had no trouble distributing the last 4 quarts, and I assure you there's demand for more.
We'll see about that. For now, you owe me 5,000 crowns for the last batch.
We agreed on 4,000, and I don't like cheats. I suggest you refrain from trying to pull anything lest you feel a witcher's blade in your gut, right?
Don't care who owes who or how much, but this man is supposed to pay me. So I'd rather he not get fleeced.
Witcher or not, you can't hope to drop us all.
Wanna find out?
Peace brings prosperity. Strife's bad for business. Fine, make it 4,000. Let's go.
Pure pleasure doing business with you. Well, that went better than I ever expected.
We done with our walk?
Yes. And here's your pouch.
One question. Who buys your Fistek?
Oh, friends in high places. I have many. They pay exceedingly well, though they're demanding as clients. The Fistek must be of the purest variety. Pleasure meeting you.
Tris, we helped her at our house get rid of rats, and now we are here in this fine city of Novigrad, heading to our next target.
Just passing by, wanderer? Or do you seek something specific?
Who's asking?
Rudolf de Jonkier. Of those de Jonkiers, yes. My ancestors laid the foundations of this city. I now own its largest bank.
Didn't need a recommendation. Name would have been enough.
Father always said, all ought to know your merit, son. Don't hide them under a bushel.
I'm looking for Corinne Tilly.
You've come to the right place, then. Corinne is inside. Been there for a few days, dreaming the home's history.
Why do you need to know the house's history? You a historian or on a whim?
I bought this property a short while ago. Paid a pretty penny, I might add. Soon after, I witnessed disturbances. Led me to fear the home might be haunted.
What are the symptoms?
Oh, they vary. Giggling in the night, and furniture moving about in the attic, and last week... Well, you shan't believe it. I found human feces in the parlor.
All right.
I'd like to go inside, look around.
I don't usually let strangers rummage around my home. Twin swords, though. You're a witcher. You may enter, call that my whim. Truth is, we're already dependent on the black bubbles, economically.
One there. Knock knock. Where is the ghost?
Put it down, please. That's blood. Don't spill it. Please. Stop. Go away. Leave it.
Don't.
Wake up. It's just a dream. Wake up.
Seems to be unable to exit her dream.
The doll. The attic.
All right. Time to check the attic.
Stop! Go away! Don't do that. Leave it! Put it down,
came from there, I guess.
That's blood! Don't spill it! Please!
Oh, no. Basement, I guess. Or to use the ladder.
Wait, the next room's blocked.
But nothing in the chest. I'm gonna read it. Examine the drawing. Where is this drawing? Okay.
There was a cradle on the second floor. Wonder what would happen if I laid a doll in it.
Blood! Don't spill it! Please!
Was there a creep there? Oh, okay.
Another masterpiece. An oven and a blackened grate. Oh joy, a riddle. Guess I should find an oven.
Oven.
Boo! Did I scare you? Scared you, didn't I? Can tell you was scared. Big brave man scared of wee little Sarah. Ain't that funny?
I wouldn't do that anymore if I were you, Sarah. You might scare someone so bad they'll hurt you.
Why would someone hurt me? Having a spot of fun's not allowed anymore.
What are you playing?
That lady fell asleep, and I've sent her some horrible dreams. I'll not her wake neither. I can do that, you know. Funny, isn't it?
Very funny. Thing is, I gotta talk to the dreamer. So I'd like you to let her wake up.
Little Sarah doesn't want her to wake. Little Sarah wants to play.
You're lucky. I know you're a harmless godling, but others might not know, and then...
And how'd you know I'm a godling, eh? How's that, eh? Eh?
If it looks like one and acts like one, trust me, you're a godling. You give the dreamer nightmares and won't let her wake up. Why are you tormenting her?
I'm not tormenting anyone. Scary dreams are great. What I love is when this big end chases me. End's got these red...
Why do you live in a haunted house?
Tell you a secret. The house ain't haunted. Not one bit. I just pretend it is, make everyone think that. It was sitting there all empty, so I moved in. Bigwig from the bank then came and bought it. I don't like bankers, especially not to live with, so I decided to give him a scare.
Gave the banker a really big scare. See, he paid a lot for this house and won't give it up easily, which is why you need to find another home.
I don't want to! I don't! I won't!
Sarah, Novigrad's no place for a godling. But if you want to live here, that's your business. So let's make a deal.
A deal? What kind?
Leave the dreamer alone. In exchange, I'll tell the banker the house is haunted. For good, no way to lift the curse.
You tell him that? What if he doesn't believe you?
I'm a witcher. He'll believe me.
Yes? 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 Do that, and I promise not to bother your friend, not even a little. You're awfully nice, you know.
I don't hear that often. Thanks.
Now go wake that sleepyhead. I won't stop her. She'll get up.
Okay, what do we have here? Oh, very nice. Hidden treasure. The bits. Very cool. Let's try to work here. Up. Hello.
Who are you?
Triss Merigold sent me to see you.
Gods. Horrible nightmares. I was supposed to dream the history of this house. Instead, I saw furniture. Hungry furniture that wished to devour me. I know it must sound foolish, but in the dream, well, it was all too real. And not at all amusing.
The work of a godling. She made people believe the house was haunted. Also injected your dreams with her little jokes.
And you managed to wake me. I feel fortunate.
We witchers have our ways.
I thank you very much. The dreams, they were awful. Any way I can pay you back?
There is, actually. I'm looking for a young woman who was seen in Novigrad.
I can certainly try to help, but I'll need to clear my head first. After those deranged dreams, I feel it's full of cobwebs. Find me at the Golden Sturgeon. I rent a room there.
All right. See you there.
I saw Miss Corrine leave, but she refused to speak to me. Is the matter resolved, or quite the opposite?
A bit of both. A demon had captured Corrine. I managed to free her, but the house is still haunted.
Did Corrine dream of the building's past?
Yeah. Pretty horrid, apparently, though she refused to talk about it. Nobody should inhabit the place.
So many crowns I paid! Oh, well. It shan't put me in the poorhouse. The second sword, is it in case the first one breaks? Smart.
Need something?
What do you...
I'll keep those boots. Let's try to dismantle. What does it give? Only crap. Okay, I'm gonna dismantle this one, I guess. Got many linen. Many thread. Many leather scraps. Oh well, I don't need those materials. Cotton. I don't see cotton, but from thread I guess I can make cotton.
So long.
Ah, no glass tastes as sweet.
Where are you, lady?
A dream in here.
Never witnessed a seance like this before, let alone participated.
I will guide you. You must first achieve a kind of mental accord. I must ask some questions. You must answer them. It's important you're truthful. Answer from your heart.
Your gift. Tell me how it works.
It's hard to describe. To start with, I must gain an understanding of the bond between the person and the object I'm to dream about. I ask questions, try to flesh out feelings, emotions. Truth is essential in this. And though most who come to me acknowledge that, many refuse to speak openly of certain matters. Apart from which, they remain unaware of others, further obscuring things.
What do you see in your dreams?
I don't. It's my client who sees. My gift lies in summoning the right dreams. At times, nightmares or strong desires impose themselves on true events. It takes skill to separate seed from chaff.
Let's begin.
To start with, tell me a memory you have of this woman.
What for?
Do as I ask, please. I need the strongest, most complete memory you have of...
Ciri. The woman's name is Ciri. It was after her time training at Kaer Morhen. After the moment when Yennefer first called Ciri her daughter. We'd been separated. I knew she was in danger. I dreamt of her multiple times. I found her at Stega Castle. She'd gone there to free Yen and gotten herself captured in the process. They wanted to hurt her. I remember fighting side by side with Ciri on stairs slippery from blood. It was the first time she ever deflected a crossbow bolt with her sword. Told her never to try it again.
These memories, they're intense. Do you wish to continue?
No. Let's continue.
You claim the woman has abilities. Tell me about them.
They call Ciri the Lady of Space and Time. Once I asked Yennefer why, she travels between worlds. Turns out I don't know how to talk about it. Didn't really understand much of what Yen told me. I just know there's more to it than traveling to different places, and that Ciri carries immense power in her blood.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
No. Can we start?
Naturally. I knew you cared about her. But your tone, the emotions you so carefully conceal.
Let's continue, please.
Make yourself comfortable and try to relax. You must take my hand and talk of Ciri. Tell me where you think she might be. Who could be at her side?
If Ciri couldn't find me, I'm sure she would have looked for another friend.
Who do you mean?
Maybe Dandelion. They liked each other a lot. Of a swallow at first. After that, just nightmares.
At times, the dreams can multiply. Show the past as well as the future.
The swallow. It symbolizes Ciri. She contacted Dandelion. I didn't know he was in town.
The poet. Heard about him. Someone left him the Rosemary and Thyme in their will.
The Rosemary and Thyme? Where's that?
As you enter the city through the Red Light District, you come upon a bridge. The Rosemary is just past it.
Dandelion inherited a brothel?
So I've heard.
Thanks for your help.
Good luck, Witcher. I hope you find your Ciri.
Those guards.
Come back, you stinking stank! Next time I'll rip your fucking legs off and shove them up your ass till you've toes for teeth! Gear up in the nick of time, as always!
Zoltan. With your boot to someone's ass, as always. Who were those men?
Local color. I wasn't going more than a moment. Long enough for them to turn our home into theirs. All right, time for some spring cleaning. I've got to boot them all out. Care to join me?
With pleasure.
Gotta get around here!
You can't kill him! Rumble time!
Reminds me of a piece of...
Yeah, almost like you never left Bergen.
That's it, you're in for it! Told you.
Leg it!
Oh, please. That went well. Now we can greet each other like the gods ordained. Ages now.
Hey, Zoltan. You look good.
Training plenty lately. What with the war on, no Mahakaman meat to be found, but Redanian lagers standing in just fine. You, though, you've withered a bit. Something worrying you.
It's about Ciri. I know she came to Novigrad. Might still be here.
You mean she's come back? I'll be damned. I wonder if I'd recognize her. How many years is it now? Six? Seven? But what'd she be doing here?
Hiding, probably. She might be in danger.
See her in your dreams?
Couple times. Her and the Wild Hunt.
Oh, not good.
Not at all. But I know she came here and contacted Dandelion.
We've a wee problem, then.
Where's the Dandelion?
Where's Dandelion?
I'd like to know that myself. Maybe he can explain what the hell's going on. I just failed to return as you saw. I'm expecting to come home to a hot leg of boar and some cold ale. What do you find instead? A shite storm. Dandelion gone, the tavern chock full of bums. I've no clue what happened.
Let's look around. Might find something that'll put us on his trail.
Prime idea. I say we start on the ground floor. It's where he sat and wrote. Aha! A note from a grateful mute.
Hmm. 10 barrels of Toussaint Dry, 5 cases of sodden triple mead. Hmm. Nothing here.
No! That's exactly what we're looking for!
What?
It's his planner!
Huh. Dandelion and planning? Good one. Besides, anything he wrote here probably had a special system. Chaos only he could ever decipher. Actually, in the past, sometimes not even that.
Give him a chance. Might not be that bad. Seems when he inherited this fine establishment, it came with some fine responsibilities. Bookkeeping among them. He also made a habit of noting down the times of his meetings, official and private. So, who'd he been seeing of late? Ah, here it is. Seems he's only been meeting women of late, the dog.
Hmm, not a bad idea. Dandelion's pretty loose-lipped. Might have blabbed something to a lady friend that'll put us on his trail.
That's what I'm counting on. We should divide these somehow. Perhaps... Ah, fuck it. I'll ask the lassies in my half, you interrogate the ones in yours. Should you?
Zoltan, wait. This is in verse.
And you figure that's unnatural because...
Wonderful. Meet me back here when you're done. Share our findings.
Right, yeah. Need to do a wee bit of tidying before I go. Cannot stomach the idea of coming back to this mess. And you'd be wise to read your bit before you scurry off. If you need anything, I'll be next door.
Broken floors.
From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the fruit of the fruit of the vine like Dandelion.
This is the loot he got from the elves of Dol Buthana.
Aye. Must have been in a great rush to leave it behind.
Should they interact?
From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the fruit of the fruit of the vine like Dandelion.
Okay, I'll put those boots, I guess. Dandelion's planner. Alright. Okay, Zoltan. What do you say?
Still here? Looking for something?
Ach, just checking to see that everything's in place. Buggers might have hauled something off for pawning.
Actually, glad you're still here. Wanted to ask you about someone. A figure most rare, her nature dual. Look deep in her eyes or be made a fool. Well, well, seems fascinated with this one.
Not without reason. Never been much for elven women myself, but this one's exceptional. Dare say Francesca Finderbeard be jealous.
You want to take this one, then?
Nah, you can have her.
Why?
See, elven beauty's like a young Beauclair wine, whereas I prefer vodka straight up.
Like a rose abashed of its crimson hue, fair Rosa would sink into humor's blue. She shunned her lessons in civility to swing her dwarf with agility. Dwarf? Never suspected he'd be so humble.
Dwarfs, what Rosa Var Atre named her Gwyhir. Well chosen, eh?
All right. But Var Atra? Her dad happened to be the Nilfgaardian ambassador.
Yes. You know him?
Wouldn't say that. Had a brief conversation with him at the palace in Vizima.
Well, then you've a good notion of the kind of bloke he is. Commissioned Dandelion to tutor Rosa and her sister in the art of rhetoric. But we Rosa preferred swordplay.
How dare she reject the great bard in favor of a common swordmaster?
More than one, it seems. Week on week, we get fresh gossip about her thrashing another instructor. So bad he resigns. Word has it her dad's now looking to hire her next victim. I mean, instructor.
Vespula. Name rings a bell. She threw his knickers out the window.
That's her.
Hollered something about him being a scoundrel with a voice like a consumptive pheasant.
That's her.
Threw flower pots at him.
Guess soul flames never die.
If I didn't know him better, I'd say he was jealous about this Marabella.
Oh, doubt it. Former pupil. And well, the tales he told me about her.
Doubt I want to hear them.
Probably better off not. Things between them took a turn for the strange at some point.
Meaning?
She had him wearing mummer's costumes. Took to calling him Christian, referring to herself as Anastasia.
Huh, truly perverse.
He did a kind of half of it. Called him a stallion once. That's the fool took it as a compliment. Till she pulled a bit in the reins into her cupboard. Poor bastard fled out the window.
What a woman, Molly.
Though well she knows the touch of silken lace, she shuns not straw when gripped in lust's embrace.
Molly keeps things tidy for the Baroness Lavalette.
A baroness within reach and he settled for a chambermaid?
Dandelion's not one to judge folk by their station. You know that. Like he says, in the alcove, we're all equals.
Yeah. Guess a true poet observes life in all its aspects, examines it from all perspectives. Well, know about all I wanted to know. Thanks for your help.
Go check these girls. We have Vespula. We'll begin with her.
I bloody well told him not to stick his arse where he don't belong.
I will get you every last copper, with interest. Give me a week, please.
Horson's no banker. He's an honest man. You pay on time, you get protection. You don't pay.
Help!
What you hollering for, stupid wench? What are you hoping for? A knight in shining armor?
Close enough.
Keep out of this, Greyhead. Not your concern.
What?
Vespula's got someone else's protection now.
Really? Who's that be?
Mine. Offered her a better rate.
All right. So, let's see if you're a good bargain or just cheap shit.
Try to take me.
Thank me. It was nothing.
Sorry. Don't get me wrong, I'm grateful, but everything I had, I just lost.
Relax. It'll come out in the wash.
Of course it will. Just gotta soak it in white vinegar, but that's not my point. Junior shan't forgive me. Either I'll close up shop myself or he'll burn me down.
Sorry. Didn't think about that.
A woman's lot. Men have their fun and we're stuck with a mess. Oh, well. I suppose I must move to Oxenfurt. Professors need clean undergarments, too.
Don't know if you remember. We've met.
I don't... Wait, I know you. You're that witcher I near clobbered with a vase when... Well...
When you kicked Dandelion out. Through the balcony. Actually, he's the reason I'm here. Know where he is?
Probably out whoring. That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, strolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse. Then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his ear.
This woman he was with in the harbor. Who was she?
Claimed she was his niece from Kovir. Ha! Horvir, more likely. Corset so tight her eyes were popping out her head. His too, come to think of it. An artist or a whore. Doesn't much matter as they're one in the same.
Dandelion ask you about other washerwomen? Not terribly subtle, even for him.
Maybe he likes some sudsy.
Maybe. But what did he ask about, exactly?
Oh, this and that, really. What's it like at the bathhouse? Have I got any friends there? What are their working hours? I don't know. Maybe he's looking to hire one for his tavern. Maybe I got all in a huff for no reason.
Sounds good, Luke.
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but it would be nice if he dropped by.
May tomorrow be better than yesterday.
Nothing to look from the... Ah, yes. obviously. Elihal. Let's go then.
Ah!
Won't let them boss you around, eh?
I'm a friend of Dandelion's, looking for Elihal.
You've come to the right spot. How might I be of service? Need something shortened? Patch your trousers, darn your socks.
You, Elihal?
Yes. Now pick your jaw up off the floor.
Sorry, I thought. Thought Elihal was one of Dandelion's girlfriends.
Ah, oh, so it's that. Wait here. Any better?
Well.
So you're...
Elihal.
Did you and Dandelion... I mean... How did you two meet?
I met him one night in a tavern. He was blind drunk.
What happened?
What do you think? We spoke.
That's it.
I'm not sure what you're getting at. But I should make one thing clear. Men don't interest me. Told him that as well. Luckily, Dandelion's an open-minded fellow. We had a lovely evening. He became a loyal customer afterwards.
All Thanks right. for your help. And nice to meet you.
I can help with much more. If you need new trousers or a vest, you know where to find me.
Hey, level 14.
Greetings. Come to look over my spring collection, perhaps?
Oh, playing cards.
Glad to take a glance at what you got.
Of course, please do. If anything chafes or pinches, I can alter it on the spot at no charge. Once I'm done, it'll feel like you're wearing nothing at all.
All right. Burn mask. Okay, those are quest items. I'm gonna buy them. That's it. I'm gonna play cards.
Wouldn't
too.
Mind a few rounds of cards.
Okay, next step. Marabella. Put my horse for this.
Gideon.
Cool. You have more like this?
hate you too, fat girl.
Oh, very good.
You again? Want some more? Oh, no. Bruises on your ass heal already?
On God, I say! Victory will be mine this time!
It's the guy he defeated.
With shield and sword, many a headless scarecrow around here. Heed my warning and stand and fight!
Duly heeded. Now show me what you got.
What? Warning? I think it was like season.
No! I yield!
Had enough?
Yes, but next time...
Go back to Mate Bilberry and apologize for being an ass. Quick, before I change my mind and break your bones.
We shall meet again!
You don't look at all like other Dwan.
What's this?
Blood's all sucked out. A lesser vampire? Blood, but not human. Monster was wounded. Not the marks of a Garkane or a Fletter. Gotta be an Ekimara. On the other side.
Following the thread. Because it's a contract. Nope. Following the thread, what is it? I don't see tracks there. Ah, yes.
Heki Mara came out of the water here. Gotta look for more tracks.
Dead rats. Second vampire.
Greetings, Lambert.
Damn, it's good to see you, Wolf.
Decide to do some hunting in Novigrad? For as I remember, you never liked this city.
Still don't. Thing is, I got a certain matter to take care of.
What have you been up to? Any luck on the path?
A lot, in fact. Quite the takings in Land Exeter. Was asked to hunt down a giant who turned out to be a forest troll and some bandits.
Bandits.
Came as a package with the troll.
The matter you mentioned. Anything I can help with?
Maybe. But we'll talk about that later. Got a reward to collect. I'm kinda in a hurry. Let's say you've earned half. What the hell?
Let's go.
So?
What do you think? We did what we had to do. Time to pay up.
Wait here, I'll go see the supervisor, get your reward.
Do that ourselves. No reason you should abandon your post.
Can't argue with reason. Go on in.
We dealt with the monster at the docks. Here for our reward.
Witches? Since when do you travel in pairs?
A lot of dangers lie in wait for a lone witcher. Bandits, for example.
I advise you to change your tone.
Where's Yad Kerridan? Talk.
Who?
Trust me, Geralt, this is important. There's something I gotta know.
I do not know any Kerridan. Take your coin for the before and bugger off, before I lose my temper.
Where's Yad Kerridan? Asking you for the last time.
Guards! To the dungeon with them!
One less. Well, they are 12. Chests. More with his chests.
This guy's more trouble than the Ekimara.
The Caridin's disappeared. I swear. The others too. I only know of Vien.
What about Vien?
She drinks at the Seven Cats. They're day and night.
See? You can be helpful.
Necessary.
Yes.
More guardsmen will show soon. Let's go. Meet me at the Seven Cats. Tell you everything there.
The Tavern Vienne frequents?
Yeah, see you later.
And we defeated the vampire. Where is the vampire? Monster hair and sort of and hide. So I came across this guarded treasure. I'm gonna check. Oh, yes, it is. Somewhere with a hammer. Guarding a black magic doll. And I was there.